and welcome to Microsoft Digital Now. I'm Andrew Wilson, Microsoft's Chief Digital Officer. Today, technology is at the heart of every business. Its mission criticality, its speed, is something we're all having to deal with. On this series of conversations, I'm looking forward to speaking with friends, industry leaders, both within Microsoft and across the industry, about how they're tackling digital and wider business transformation. So let's get to it. Hello. Every organization these days needs a digital strategy, whatever the industry, whatever the geography. And that's no less so in a technology organization. Joining me today is my good friend Cindy from Adobe. Hi, Cindy.
Hello, how are you?
I'm good, good to see you. Thanks for spending time with us. Now, from your perspective, first, give us a little bit of a background on your role at Adobe, and also Adobe's current situation as a modern technology enterprise.
Yeah, so let me talk a little bit about Adobe first. You know, we're not a baby of a company. We were formed in 1982, so we just turned 40 years old, if you can believe that. And we have three major solution areas. First is Creative Cloud, you know, offers the creative tools that most people think about when they hear the Adobe name. We also have the Document Cloud. You know, this houses our digital document solutions like Acrobat, Adobe Sign, Adobe Scan. And then we also have our Experience Cloud, which help customers manage journeys, you know, their customer journeys, you know, which include data analytics, some personalization, commerce, marketing, you know, anything in that, really into that space for long-term customer success. And together, you know, these clouds come together to, you know, form everything that we do for our customers. And my role is as CIO, I support the technology that, you know, brings Adobe business to life. We also support, you know, running the different clouds and making sure that our services have great experiences. And, you know, the third is the data infrastructure for the company and making sure that we provide, you know, insights and things that we need in order to manage the business. So all in all, it keeps me a little bit busy during the day.
And from your perspective, what is the transformation agenda that you lead at Adobe?
Yeah, so that's a great question. And, you know, I'm the CIO, and like many CIOs, I would say we sit at the nexus of the company transformation and innovation, because you know, we're horizontal, and also we've had to really enable the organizations to be able to perform over the last few years. I would say that in our case, creativity is a great tenant for Adobe, and I think it applies to our digital transformation initiatives as well. For example, in my organization, I have what I call a digital workplace experience team who work tirelessly to, you know, formulate the employee experience, you know, the different personas, tools, you know, how we move to the workplace of the future. And, you know, this is not something new. We've actually had this for about 4 to 5 years. And we borrowed from our focus, our external focus on customer experiences, and said, okay, how do we use that same mantra? And how do we bring our internal employee experiences to life and make them great? So our goal is really to enable the global workforce to collaborate, innovate, and be productive from anywhere. And I really mean from anywhere. And to do that, you know, we look at Adobe's business strategy. We look at different industry trends, you know, talk to different people. We get the voice of our customers, our employees. And, you know, we put it all together to say these are the types of flexible work experiences that we need in order to enable that intentional collaboration. And we use data. You know, I mentioned we have a data infrastructure. So we use data and we apply automation where we need to eliminate toil and also improve the experience for the employees so that they can focus on the important things. And we have robots and bots and AI focusing on those less important robotic type activities. And the last thing that I'll talk about is, you know, we do a lot of experimentation. So we like to explore cutting edge technology with our partners. And what we've created is what we call Lab 82, which is named after the year we were born, and The Garage, which is an extension of Lab 82, you know, off in a different place so that it can act as the hybrid workspace. And what we do here is we test collaborative workspace technologies with our real employees, you know, in these spaces before we actually deploy them. So we can see how people react, we can see how people use them, and we can bring things to life that are really beneficial to our employee base.
So with all that telemetry and all that experimentation you describe, is that your primary success measure? How do the Adobe customer base and the employee base hold you accountable? And what do you regard as your major success criteria?
So when I think about major success criteria, I think about happy, productive employees, efficient processes, workflows, and smooth operations. And yes, you're correct. We do look at metrics to look at those. You know, we use customer journey management practices, both internally and externally, to look at these principles. You know, for employees, we look at employee data, look at survey data. We look at, you know, how people are reacting to different technologies. The voice of the employee is extremely important, and we really take that to heart to, you know, either self-correct, go in a certain direction, or actually maybe even drop something and go in a totally different direction. You know, one of the areas in my organization is really big data at scale. You know, I feel we've unlocked and democratized some of this data so that we can look at data across the organization. We call it our unified data architecture. We actually started looking at the customer journeys, but we've expanded it to also internally use. So now we're able to use these consistent metrics, measures, and consistent ways of looking at things to measure and actually progress the organization. So business insights is really key, and those metrics and actually using them to change your course or continue down the course is absolutely important.
Well, I know you, in your role as a technology leader within a technology company, face similar challenges myself in terms of our customers are the technologists. Does that change the role of CIO and CDO, do you think, from any other industry?
Yeah, you know, that's an interesting question. You know, I think that, you know, years ago I would have answered yes to that question. But today I would probably not say it's different because every company really needs to be a technology company in some respect because the walls between IT and the business, you know, have come down and it really should be harmonized because IT should be an enabler. And actually, we should have, you know, business experts and business units that understand technology just as well as, you know, I would say, you know, the traditional IT organization should. And, you know, what I find in my job is, you know, every day is different. It's extremely interesting, inspiring. And what I love to see is people harnessing creativity and innovation to solve complex problems. You know, one of the things that we've done within my organization, ATS, Adobe Technology Services, is we've embraced values to say we should have cloud-like characteristics in our DNA, meaning that we're easy to work with, we're easy to use. You know, we embrace self-service, different techniques of actually enabling the business as opposed to, you know, coming waiting in the, you know, in the IT development line. So, you know, when we see this, you know, we actually reward people for different behaviors. So we reward people who exemplify these different characteristics. We do this quarterly at my all hands, and it's a great way to reinforce and communicate this benefit to the entire organization. And it's actually matured over the past few years because we used to have a lot of the nominations come directly from my own organization. But now we see business people, you know, nominating people for, you know, some of the things that they've done and how they've enabled the business, which is great to see those nominations come in. You know, similar to yourself and many other, you know, CIOs, I think that, you know, we all have a unique horizontal view across the organization. And when you look horizontally, you know, you can spot things over here that maybe are impacting somebody over there. And you can broker those conversations and actually bring teams together to look at business processes and solution in a more holistic manner. You know, additionally, my team, we often act as customer zero for our products, you know, working with our product teams and maintaining these relationships and bringing the customer voice into those conversations is really, really important. You know, I've said it for, you know, many years, but I really believe that the correlation between happy employees, satisfied customers, and overall business success, it all comes together. And that's really the key, how an organization can keep employee experience at the forefront and really, you know, continue to change and evolve over time.
One final question for you, Cindy. I know you spend a lot of time with customers. What are they asking you, and what trends do you see that are keeping them up at night at the moment?
Yeah, so, you know, I think that, you know, if you think back over the last few years, you know, people have been taking on, you know, digital transformation for years, but there wasn't really that trigger, that oomph to really get them going and get the adoption. So I think a lot of people are, you know, really wondering, what are the best practices? What are those lessons learned? How do you fast track it? You know, how do I get from A to Z very quickly? So, you know, people want to enable. I see a big focus on enabling the employee experience, collaboration in different forms, being able to communicate, being able to, you know, respect the time of the day and things like that when you're collaborating. So if you have a team on the other side of the world, you know, let the content sit and lie and let them collaborate, and it's there when you wake up in the morning. So, you know, just looking at how you can bring collaboration and digitization to life within the organization, really important. And then, you know, using some of those same techniques we've used with, you know, external customers as well. And then a huge focus on the customer experience. Customers have choices, right? Customers have choices. They can go to many different places for different services. So what I do is I encourage my team to put themselves in the shoes of the customers that we have. You know, think about what you would expect from customer support. Think about what you would expect from responsiveness and reliability and all the things that we can, you know, impact. And then, hey, whatever you expect, bring it to life, because those are the types of experiences we want our customers to have.
A great example of a modern technology leader in action. Cindy, it's great to catch up. It's great to catch up with you as always. I wish we could spend more time. Knowing a little bit about you, you're a good friend. I know you to be a little bit of a horticulturalist, a gardener. And yes. I can see your plants there in the office. We have a little tradition on the show. Although we're joining virtually today, we have here in the studio a little gift, which I'm going to make sure we get to you quite quickly. It's, I hope you can see this. It's a Lego bonsai tree. I'm noticing a gap on the shelf over your right shoulder, and I'm hoping that by next week we'll see the bonsai tree there. So from everyone on the show, Cindy, great to catch up with you. Thank you, and we look forward to seeing you again soon.
Thank you so much. It's wonderful to see you.
And we'll see you again next time.